So great news is about a girl who works at a cable news show, and her mom, who is based on my mom, was a stay-at-home mom for the last 30 years, and she sort of decides it's not too late to follow her dreams and get a big career, and she gets an internship at her daughter's workplace. I kind of got the idea because I was a TV writer starting in my 20s. I wrote on 30 Rock and on the Mindy Project, and my mom used to come visit set all the time and just love being on set and meeting people and hanging out. And so I sort of just thought, like, wouldn't it be a funny, a fertile ground for comedy if a mom came to her daughter's work and just never left? Mm-hmm. I've been so lucky. Right. I mean, I got my first like writer's assistant job when I was in my early 20s working for Tina Fey. And I mean, who gets that lucky that they really get to learn how to write television and how to break episodes and pitch jokes and stuff from someone like her. And her and Robert Carlock, just from being around them and sitting in the writer's room and observing them for, you know, the six right. years that I worked there, I feel like I picked up so much about how to write, but also how to be a boss and how to manage people and make deadlines and be a showrunner.
I'm so proud of her. I'm not surprised because I knew she had it in her.
Yeah.
And I'm very proud of her, what she's done.
And that's what's so nice about having your mom with you. Like, there's no other person that literally from when you were a tiny kid was like, you're gonna make it, you're gonna be, there's something great planned
well,
for
really,
you, except
why
for your
put
mom.
A ceiling or a wall on your hopes and your dreams? You know, go for it. If someone else can do it, you can do it.
And what's the best thing you think she said?
There is a line that got cut that we didn't end up using, but we have to use in season two, where she was like, I don't know if I have enough saved for retirement. I got to think of an invention.
I say that all the time.
Because it was like such like a, I mean, she has a million of them all the time, but like it's such a funny, like she's such sort of like a hopeful sort of, yeah, like sort of a dreamy person that the idea that like, oh, if you don't save enough for retirement, oh, just make an invention. What a bad plan.